The pooling operation using convolutional neural networks is a big mistake, and the fact that it works so well is a disaster, is a quote by the legend himself, Geoffrey Hinton, regarding the pooling operations that are commonly used in convolutional neural networks. And as a solution to these issues that appear when those layers are employed, he proposed the Capsule Network. In this video, I would like to dig deeper into this topic and discuss what Geoffrey Hinton had in his mind when he proposed this new type of neural network. Let's start with the beginning, convolutional neural networks. Most of you that are watching this video should be familiar with this type of neural network, so I won't cover it here. But in case you are not familiar, I've added a link in the description to a great introduction to this topic. Well, one of the issues that this neural network has is that although CNNs achieve the best results in image classification, they are actually pretty bad in classifying objects in different poses, and to achieve good performance, a lot of training data is needed. This is because CNNs are not equivariant but invariant to pose changes. What does this mean? Equivariance means that when the input changes, the output should change the same way. Invariance, in contrast, means that when the input changes, the output should not change. And because CNNs are made to be invariant, this makes them robust against translation changes, which may sound like a good idea for models working on images at the first glance, but it can backfire in unfortunate ways. And as a result, other pose changes, like the exact location of features, are not handled well due to the pooling operation, which throws away valuable information from the input image in order to increase the field of view in the deeper layers, which are responsible for making the classifications. To overcome this problem involving the feature relationships in the images, Hinton drew inspiration from neuroscience. He explains that the brain is organized into modules, which can be considered capsules. With this in mind, he proposed capsule networks, which incorporate dynamic routing algorithms to estimate features of objects like size, orientation, or rotation. So, what does he mean by that? Well, the best way I can describe is by thinking in computer graphic terms, where you have some kind of vectors and parameters that you use to render an object. The capsule network goes the other way around and infer those parameters from the input image. So instead of only providing us a probability, as the CNNs do, the output of a capsule network is a vector where the length of the vector reflects the probability that a specific object is present, while the orientation encodes the instantiation parameters. The resulting vectors are then fed into the higher-level capsule using what Hinton describes as the routing by agreement algorithm that determines which lower capsule reports to which higher-level capsule. For instance, if one of our low-level capsules detected the following rectangle and another one the following triangle at the bottom of the image, then the routing algorithm would transfer their outputs to the capsule that detects a house, resulting in a match. What's interesting about this example is that if those two shapes were somewhat far from each other, due to the pooling layers in CNNs, the exact location of those two components would have been lost, so the model may have predicted that this is a house. On the other hand, if we employ the capsule network, this would not happen, since the low-level capsules would not have detected both the triangle and the rectangle at the same time, and as a result, the higher-level capsule responsible for representing the house would not activate. To illustrate those concepts better, let's take a look again at this harder example. What a CNN model could see is that there is an eye that resembles some training sample, so some neurons would activate. Here is another eye that resembles some training samples, so another neuron would fire. The mouth would also resemble some training samples, and in the end, it would conclude that this is indeed a face, which is obviously not really true. And again, the reason behind this is that the CNN model detects those patterns, such as the eyes or nose, but it doesn't have a clear relationship behind them. On the other hand, if we fed the same image to a capsule network, it will most likely not make the same mistake, since although the low-level capsules would detect each individual feature, after this information is routed to the corresponding higher-level capsules, The latter will not fire since they will not get all the necessary inputs. Okay, and now that we've got an intuitive idea of what Capsule Network do and what problem they are trying to solve, I believe we can delve a little bit deeper and take a look at the mathematics. So given a list of pose vectors, UI, we rotate and translate them using a matrix WYG into a vector U hat G given Y that predicts the output of the parent capsule. Then the capsules HG in the higher level are fed the sum of the predictions from all capsules in the lower layer, each with a coupling coefficient CYG that are computed by applying the routing softmax function on the log probabilities BYG. Finally, we apply the squash nonlinearity to obtain the output of the capsule. And that's basically it. Thank you for watching this video. Please leave a like if you enjoyed it. Let me know what you think about Capsule Networks in the comments below. And until next time, I hope you have an amazing time. See you!